I got a bad sense about this man. Richie needs to work his shit out with Georgie.
Well, he ain't got no fucking choice. Because if he don't, we are fucked like yo mama on prom night.
For sure, ma'am, for sure. Well, better get back to it before Bobby starts hollering again.
All right, then. Watch your ass down there.
Best not be screwing with me.
Fine. Best not be screwing with me. y'all. Oh, you like the story? Well, I just happen to have one. So why don't you sit for a spell and have a listen to my tale about that devil beast known as the Rougarou. It all began in a small Negro village nestled deep in the bayou. It was a place where slaves ran behind from the world and hoped to call home. But something else called this place home too. Something evil. And it was watching. Waiting. Now say what you will about the life of a slave, but those days brought the Negro one closer to God. Saved many a soul from the lake of fire. But soon they started backsliding, returning to the ways of their African ancestors. And an elder named Papa Virgil led them back to that old heathen practice known as voodoo. And good old Papa Virgil, well, he took on a new name, Baron Saturday. That evil in the darkness knew this was his time.
Some kind of evil was getting started.
Men, women, even children started going missing. The great fear took hold of folks, and a name was whispered throughout the village. The Rougarou. A fierce man beast covered in fur. A mouth of razors with claws to match. Many Negro men went hunting the Rougarou, but none of them returned. Desperate to fend off that beast, the simple-minded folks scarred the banks of the bayou with voodoo dolls. Horrific things made of human bones and hair, and painted in blood. But this dissuaded the Rougarou not one bit. And some say things
fucking
got
weird.
Worse. Much worse.
Say
the
something,
hero
man!
They needed came in the form of a young priest, Father Michael.
You better not be screwing with me!
The Lord called Father Michael to save those lost sheep who gone astray and killed the Rougarou. He stalked the beast for days, but in the end returned to the village. Empty-handed.
Guide me, O Lord my God. I serve only your will.
That night, Father Michael woke to terrified cries still in his ears. The Rougarou. And as the fear-filled villagers ran far from the beasts, Father Michael ran toward them.
This through, boy. You think you can come in here and steal my heroin without nobody noticing?
I'm not here to steal your heroin, Richie. I'm here to make you pay for what you did to Sammy and Ellis Robinson.
I didn't have nothing to do with it!
I watched you stab Ellis in the gut. I couldn't do nothing about it then, but I sure as hell can now.
God damn it! None of that was my idea, you hear? It was all Georgie, him and his old man. They wanted y'all gone, not me. What was I supposed to do? Say no?
Either that or make sure that I was dead.
Oh, no, no, no. No, please. Please. Listen. Listen. Just decent thing would be to let a man get in a prayer before you kill him.
You can pray on the way up.
When I saw Richie Doucette hanging from that Ferris wheel, I felt a profound sense of disbelief. Nothing like this had ever happened before. You mobsters killed each other all the time, but it was generally a small, contained event. Some greaseball is eating spaghetti and meatballs at his favorite restaurant and gets popped in the head. But this was different. Even then, even before I knew who killed him, I knew that Richie had been put on display. Lincoln was trained in psychological warfare by the CIA. He wanted to terrify the mob, wanted them to know he was going to kill every last one of them, and that none of them would be able to stop him.
Seth's dead. The Hollow's yours.
They say you strung him up on the old Ferris wheel.
He killed Ellis. Shit all over the people in this neighborhood. Doucette got what he deserved.
The righteous will rejoice when he sees the vengeance. He will bathe his feet in the blood of the wicked. That goes both ways, you know.
Thought you said all that was behind us.
My men are struggling with the notion that we now have to answer to the same men who killed Baca, who wiped out half our number.
If I was them, I'd get over it. We don't have time to go around coddling people.
Of course not. But gestures carry weight. And if you were to help my man Emmanuel, that's a gesture that would go a long way in calming nerves.
What's he need?
Thank you. breaking news in New World Earth. There are reports of a violent shootout at the abandoned Baron Saturday.
About the things happening right here in New Bordeaux. Things I don't think anyone could have ever predicted. Except yours truly, of course. Seems there's a gentleman out there, maybe he's even listening right now, who police are referring to as a violent agitator. Hold on, that's not exactly right. Police are actually
come on.
Problems?
This goddamn thing keeps jamming up. If you're ready to see the other briefings, we can get started.
Show me what else you managed to dig up.
You got it. Two of the city's finest scumbags. Oh, yes. Point for Dunn's favorite son, Thomas Burke.
How's he doing since Danny?
9 weeks ago, Burke stumbles into Roman the Butcher Barbieri's deli, drunk off his ass, waving a gun around. He fires off 10 rounds, but the only thing he manages to hit is a fucking ham hock in the goddamn deli case. The butcher's boys slap the shit out of him and toss him in a dumpster.
Barbieri's the one who took over Point Verdun, right? Busted up Burke's leg with a tire iron.
That's why Burke was willing to go along with the robbery. He thought it'd make things square with Sal, and he'd be able to get Point Verdun back.
He always struck me as an asshole.
Yeah. Just like every other Irishman. But he hates Marcano as much as you do.
Yeah, all right. Least I can do is give Danny's old man a chance for a little payback. Oh, fucking hell.
He's been spending his time in a dive bar up in Point Verdun. Duffy's, it's called. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
Yo, you better be worth all this trouble.
The man himself, Mr. Vito Scaletta.
You gotta be shitting me.
Last couple months have been pretty tough on old Vito. Sal's always hated him. Thought he was a mole for the commission, but he couldn't do anything about it because Vito's maid. After the heist, Sal refused to pay Vito his cut, and then he put the clamps on him. He's been trying to limit Vito's ability to pay what's owed.
And if Scaletta can't kick up, the commissioner gave Marcano permission to whack him.
The only reason that Vito is still above ground is because he has a couple off-the-record businesses. He's been using that money to pay Sal.
Gotta give Scaletta credit. Pretty goddamn tenacious.
He's lasted a lot longer than I thought he would, but the clock is ticking. A couple weeks ago, Sal sent in his nephew, a kid named Michael Greco, to help Vito run River Row. Greco's been using his guys to limit what Vito can do, where he can go. Once he has Vito completely boxed in, he'll make his move.
Skeletta has to know what Greco has planned. I'll pay him a visit. See if I can't leverage this thing with Greco to bring Skeletta around in my way of thinking.
I'm sure I'll appreciate your concern.
Looking pretty lively for a dead guy.
Think. Vito's taking his beating. Wish Greco would just let us kill a po-
Huh?
Goddamn shooting!
Our fucking crew!
You ticked off the wrong white boy.
This day's 11. Asshole bolted. Fuck, he was right
he
here.
He ain't back there!
That shit's all him. Let's go! Oh,
Ted! I'm pinned down!
Warming him up!
Buddy.
Lob a fucking Molotov!
Let Molotov!
Get that stupid son of a bitch!